We're talking to Malik Scott, one of the most brightest coaches in boxing. We're just 2 weeks out from Deontay Wilder, Joseph Parker. Talk to me. What's going on? How's camp?
Good, man. It's a short camp, but we're getting a lot of work done in a short time, a lot of smart, hard work. Not really going overboard too much, but we're ready to go to work, and Deontay is ready. And we're going to put Joe Parker away, man, in grand fashion. We're going to give Saudi Arabia a treat.
I followed Deontay for many, many years. This is the best I've seen him, offense, defense, explosive conditioning, everything. Mm-hmm. Fans are going to be in a treat come fight night.
Well, you got to realize he's been inactive as far as having a fight and everything, but periodically during a lot of moments of time, he's always been staying sharp. So I look at it like he's been resting for a long time. So the hard work we're putting in now and the result we're about to have on December 23rd is what a well-rested body does to someone. And we have a well-rested, dangerous body. Deontay is going to put it to work come December 23rd. I can't wait.
You pick him by knockout. Of course, you said everybody's effed up.
Everybody's fucked. They're all fucked. Okay. Not just Joseph Parker, the whole division. If Deontay does things that I see him do and know that he can do and he wants to do them and he buy into a game plan, they're all fucked.
What's your prediction for Otto Wallin and Joshua?
It's a good fight, but if I was a betting man, I would go with Anthony Joshua.
Okay, what about Big Baby and Daniel Dubois?
That's going to be an interesting fight because if Dubois is not mentally tough, like he's proven he hasn't been at times, Jarrell Miller will just walk him down and chop him down and be victorious.
Did you see what Eddie Hearn said about Big Baby threatening him and said, don't come to New York, I'm going to find you?
I mean, I'm sure Jarrell say a bunch of stuff, but he's entertaining. That's one thing that he is, and it's a form of him that is good for the division and that's good for boxing. You know, we all have fucked up in life. I have fucked up. I fucked up recently. I want to fuck up next week, tomorrow sometime. Jarrell Miller did too. He's aware that he fucked up. And he's been trying to make it right and do the right thing.
He's being tested a lot right now, by the way.
Yeah, and that's good. That's good. That's good, man. Like, it's hard for me not to want good for anybody, especially in this boxing shit, because we all trying to make a living.
And he's a good dude, I know him. So. Right, you know, so, okay, yeah. How about this? Usyk Fury right now, what do you think? If it happened, it's happening February.
70-30... 50-50. I'm not really interested in the fight because even them guys, they're fucked. If Deontay does everything that I know that he can,
you don't care who wins.
I do not care. No.
I'm rooting for Usyk myself.
We know this.
Just like I'm rooting for Regis this weekend over Haney, but that's not a shocker. Who's your fighter of the year? I'm going to give you some candidates really quick. Gervonta Davis, 2 big wins this year. Mm-hmm. David Benavidez, 2 big wins this year. Crawford had a big win this year. Maybe Deontay, if he looks phenomenal. Mm-hmm.
He will.
So you like Deontay as fighter of the year after this fight?
No.
Oh, Canelo had 2 big wins too?
I would say, right now it's looking like, is Crawford in this mix?
Crawford, yeah, but he had one fight versus Benavidez, fought Plant and Boo Boo. Tank fought a 130 champ and then he fought Ryan.
It's going to be between Benavidez and Crawford, I believe. And how many times Canelo fought so far?
Twice. He fought the guy in Mexico, the British guy, and then he fought Charlo.
In my opinion, those two wins won't get it. Did he get it before, though?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, many times.
I think it should go to Benavidez or Crawford.
And then there's the beef with Ryan and Golden Boy. What do you make of that? When a fighter doesn't get along with his promoter's business, it's part of the sport.
It's very peculiar how they go about their business, man. Sometimes it can make you think, is this shit staged? Do they really not like each other? But when Bernard Hopkins get into the mix and start speaking from his heart, you know it's real business. So whatever those issues is, I don't fucking know, man.
All right. Your message to your fans, 2 weeks from today, they'll all be tuning in. They'll watch the fight. You're going to be in the corner doing your thing.
Absolutely. Watch Deontay Wilder, my fighter, my brother, my future 2-time heavyweight champion of the world. Watch him do his thing in the most violent way, in the most surgical way. They're all fucked. Not just Joseph Parker. The whole division. Hear me. Feel me. A legend has spoken.
There you have it. Make sure to follow Malik King Scott everywhere. Yes. Stay tuned. And if you ever in LA, come by Brick House. Visit Malik. Show him the jacket.
You got to get my family.
I did.
The Brick House way. Tell everybody.
There you have it. I will. Stay tuned.
Ellie, take back. Family.
Reporting.
Brick House way, baby.